can see the CT scan axial section showing the parapharyngeal abscess. That's a coronal cut showing the right parapharyngeal and the retropharyngeal abscess. That's a sagittal view of the CT scan showing the retropharyngeal abscess and part of parapharyngeal abscess. The patient had been intubated under general anesthesia. You can see the bulging of the right retropharyngeal and parapharyngeal space between the right tonsil. That's the right tonsil. The mouth has been opened with the tonsil mouth gag and a 0-degree telescope has been introduced. A white bore needle has been put to aspirate the pus. Almost 1.5 inch of the needle has been pushed into the thing. Now you can see the aspirate. It's a very thick walled and I had to pass more than 1 inch to reach the abscess with the needle. This pus will be sent for culture and AB staining. Incision is made with a monopolar knife. This is a very vascular area. So before opening, the mucosa has been incised with a monopolar knife. After making the incision, and long tonsil artery forceps has been introduced to open the thick walled sac to let the pus out. You can see pus coming through the incision site. All the pus has been sucked with the sucker and this cavity by CT scan is around 6 cm by size. Now the swelling has subsided. I am introducing a gauze piece into the abscess cavity to wipe out, take out the collections leaving behind. After the gauze has been taken out, you can see the incision site and telescope has been introduced in, and you can see the very big cavity full was collected with the pus, which has been drained out. Thank you for watching.